Right, she's not getting lost today.
Are we still exhausted?
No.
Okay.
Food and water.
Survival.
Brutus and Olaf do not find food for the day.
Give me 1 second, I'll roll.
Kilo ration.
Neither is Zach. I'll just let Preach roll food twice. All right, now we're going to be the next day. I need that group leader survival. You are not lost. Shelter's decent enough for the night. Shiza does not manage to find food. Neither does Olaf.
This will be a search for a shelter.
We found shelter.
Very well.
So I'll use it for food. But Zach and Brutus have luck tonight. And there, I'll just have Reach roll twice for food when he gets back.
Beautiful.
The next encounter.
I have no idea what you're doing, Z, but wow.
What? Wow, what?
Your mic keeps picking it up. Some type of tapping.
Oh, move this stuff around.
Yes. Okay. So right now we're in a lull. So be with us. We're waiting one of our group members to get back. And so at this time I'm going to explain a little bit of what's going on with our setting and campaign. So this is called SOTP, Sins of the Past. What happens is there is magic used to run everything the same way gas and oil runs today's world. So magic was the main purpose. And now it's the wasteland, so post-apocalyptic, magic is a very scarce resource, if any at all. We have one spellcaster, and well, we have two spellcasters in our party. One is leaving us, but he's the only spellcaster. Everybody else is not a spellcaster. And the characters that are in this game right now, we have an Ursine, which is Brutus. We have Zach Knoxwood, which is a tabaxi. You have my character, Olaf, which is a homebrewed of a wolfkin called a Yager. There's two of us. There's me, and there is Preach. Preach is also our spellcaster. You have Shiza, which is a human, was an elf that used to be part of a raider group. Doc and Peter are both going away, so I'm not going to get into the meat and potatoes of them too much. And with how we do this, if you can look on the screen right now, like, these are my macros. And go over something that's a little different. If you look, I have a grease gun, a crossbar, a trench gun, and a judge. A judge is a revolver that shoots 12 gauge. And everybody's thinking, well, how did you actually get that into D&D when there's nothing in that in D&D? So we've done all this, and you can see we have jams and everything. This is a complete homebrewed game, completely from our imagination, put into 5th edition. It used to be ran with Pathfinder, but when more of our friends got converted over to 5th edition, we had to completely break down the game and redo it in a 5th edition mindset with roles and everything, and then everything changed. And my character is a mutant, so he had a birth mutation, which he was blind, but think of the blindness as of Daredevil. So Daredevil could see through echolocation and everything, so can my character. And then I just got a new one that I have crystals. That's where I get cure wounds. They're magical crystals that have embedded into my fur, and I get 5 of those a day per long rest. Everything else is the same. You still do the charisma and all this stuff. These are my dump stats as wisdom, charisma. Proficiency is only a 2 because I'm a 4, and it's all this. And go into something else real quick while I'm here. So this is all of our stuff. If you go to rules, we'll go to leveling system. As you can tell, we have a specific thing per character. There's no, oh, my character gets this and this and this as we level up. We made it streamlined. So at everybody at 5th level gets a +2 ASI. Okay, and then their hit die is 1d10. And then you get a tier points. Tier points can be added in to get skills, excuse me, skills into expertise, into proficiency, and other stuff. You get a 3rd saving throw or increase the existing one. Increase the tool skills or learn a new one at 7th level. Feat number 2. So your 2nd feat doesn't come until 8th level. Then followed right by that is another ASI. And then here's the tier system I was talking about, tactics. This is a military game. So when I talk D&D for guys, that are in the military, but they just neglect to fucking push past it. They're like, oh, I'm an alpha male, blah, 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 blah. I'm in the military. And all that stuff. So with that, I'm going to end this stream till we get back on, just for the simple fact I'll leave it up, and then we'll go with the chat room and everything. Interact with some of the guys that are in the chat room, since we really haven't got any chances to. Oh boy. Let's go buy some shit. Oh, it's gonna be like, do you have any? Never mind. No. That was basically while Brutus was buying. He's like, do you have it? Never mind.
Yeah, I'll take it.
I did, thank you.
Me or him?
You.
Okay.
Can he check for Solothorn rounds?
He shakes his head.
You wouldn't happen to have a tent, would you?
Og has tent for sale.
How many?
Just the one.
How big?
Enough for one, two people.
So me and Olaf, and I point to, well, me and the wolf, and I point to Olaf.
Yes.
How much? Believe
that could be 25 cups.
Sold.
All right. You have a tent now.
Can I search his cart for a whetstone?
You may.
It's for the cleaver.
You search, but he does not have one.
I guess I'll just keep using other steels.
I'm going to look to Olaf. Hey, Olaf, you want to carry a tent?
Olaf's going to look at you and be like, you bought it.
For us.
Us nothing, you bought it. You buy it, you haul it.
Fine.
You don't ask me asking to carry your half ghillie around, do you? Or you don't ask me to see me carrying asking you to carry my ammo, do you?
Alright. No one else needs anything.
Og's
gonna take
Olaf asked if he had a Bowie knife.
Has the one on his belt. This only good knife Og has. Og's not for sale.
Oh, of course. Not even for 200 caps?
He shakes his head. Og's father had knife. Og's grandfather had knife. Og's great-grandfather had knife.
The family got it. Sorry I asked.
Says as he picks up his cart. Have a good day in Wasteland.
You too! Be careful of Deathclaws.
You watch out for them Legion fellers. They're around this area.
Oh, great.
He says as he starts walking off.
He looks at Cheese and be like, your mom might be there.
I'll be right back.
Alright.
I'm gonna go make my plate for dinner. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Hey,
Yes.
You didn't happen to see a rundown Scarlet Warthog camp nearby, did you?
Og saw it. Gave it Whitebird.
That way?
He nods.
Thank you. And I start walking that way.
Alright. With that, I need the...
The daily?
...for this day of travel. Alright, guys, managed to not get lost, but no good shelter for the night.
What about with that tent?
You can use the tent for shelter, yes.
Okay, me and Olaf.
Alright, Olaf and Cheeza do not suffer a level of exhaustion. For the next day.
Oh, I found no food.
Found no food. Everyone else, however, does.
Including me?
No. You and Olaf are in the tent.
We're in the tent, so they get food.
You also didn't
find food?
Yeah, cool.
Okay.
Alright. You gotta wait for... Is Zach not rolling for food?
Yeah, give me one sec.
Yeah, you don't find any food. Alright. Being said, the night passes without incident, and we move into our next.
Sandard rolls?
Not yet. So, as you guys are traveling, you see two people kind of walking in the wasteland as well. As you guys are. You guys are starting to set up camp. You can kind of see them off in the distance there.
I look at them through my scope.
Roll me a perception.
26.
One is a strangely pale-looking human man, and the other is a large black-furred yager. Both are wearing, looks like, fairly nice suits that have seen better days, carrying only the basics of supplies.
I inform... the group. I speak loud enough to inform the group as I tell Zach.
All right. I'm a little broken on my end.
I'm telling Zach that I saw a Blackford Yager and an extremely pale humanoid. You said he was human, right?
Yep.
Yeah, extremely pale, an oddly pale human. Both wearing suits and just basic supplies. Kind of walking this way.
Yourself at the ready.
I'm going to go towards the back of the camp, hide, and keep my gun trained on them.
Alright.
15.
Alright. So, you guys can go ahead and give me the rolls for the day. You guys find good shelter. She's easy to find food. Zach, you do not.
I added a third one for guiding him through.
Alright. So only she's managed to find food.
We're not having a good time on this food run this time.
No. However, as you guys have kind of set up camp and stuff like that, the two figures approach. They have now gotten closer, and the man speaks. You can tell he looks hungry. He's kind of seen better days type deal, and he goes, "Pardon me, ladies and lady and gentlemen. Me and my brother are wondering if we might share camp for the night. We're on our way to the meeting."
The Olaf is going to look at him and be like, "What's mutant about you two?"
I look to the human. I go, "Let me guess. Your skin burns in the sunlight, and you feel better at night. Like it rejuvenates you."
He shakes his head. "No, nothing. Nothing like that. Wouldn't have had to have leave Sibyllisville for that type of glitching."
I really like Thomas Shelby.
So he's going to gesture to the fire. "Is it all right if we join you for camp?"
I look to Zach.
"Camp with us?"
"Yep."
I'm going to say yes. Okay. Keep trained on them regardless.
The human man's going to hold out his hand to Zach. Thank you. My name is Thomas Shelby, and this is my brother, Arthur.
Zach's going to shake his hand. Name's Zach.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
I'm his brother, Olaf. Ah,
that is my brother, Olaf.
I see that we're not the only adopted brothers around.
I'm actually going to be nice and give them 7 rations each.
Well, that is really nice of you, but you've also been finding food every day, so not like going through them.
Yeah. Plus, I still have 17 left, so.
Nice. They're very grateful. From what you guys can tell, these two have a very close bond. You guys can roll perceptions or anything on them if you want.
What about insights?
You may. Okay. So Shiza, from what you can tell, Thomas is the only one that is a human. Arthur is not. Anyone else going to look at these guys any closer?
I rolled a 10 or 11 on perception. They're, my eyes not tinkering really well.
No, you already gave me an insight. All right, well, if no one's going, everyone's
I'm
going to
look
good.
Over like what all they have specifically.
They're both wearing kind of, like I said, these ratty-ish kind of suits, only carrying basic supplies. You do recognize, you do see on Thomas's arm at one point during the night some sort of tattoo or brand.
Hey, let me see what's on your arm?
Thomas looks at her. Why do you need to see what is on my arm?
If it's a fresh brand, I can make sure it doesn't get infected.
I assure you, it's not fresh.
Then, can you prove to me it's not something that is threatening?
Thomas kind of gestures himself. Lady, I'm not even carrying a piece.
Please, for my ease of mind.
Thomas kind of sighs. The brand is nothing to worry about, trust me.
And that makes me worried.
Then I'm sorry that makes you worried.
Olaf's going to pick up his back of his shirt and be like, I got one. I show you mine, you show me yours.
Thomas, seeing Olaf's brand, goes kind of. His eyes get a little bigger, and in retaining, he goes, I did not know I was in the company of a fellow brother.
Olaf scratches his head. Come again?
Thomas looks to Arthur. They're talking back and forth in Ruthenian. How does someone in the Broadfoot not know Ruthenian?
I'm going to look to them and be like...
starts laughing.
I'm just gonna look at Thomas and fucking Arthur and talk to them in Ruthenian. To lie with.
Huh?
I want to quickly say to Brutus.
I didn't understand that.
I'm going to speak to them in Ruthenian and ask them who they fall under, basically. Which town they come from with Bratva in it.
They say that they're from Sibyllisville.
It's just going to look extremely confused and then rifle a little tighter and ask, what are you doing all the way out here?
They're going to tell you, just like Thomas and Nathaniel say, it's just like I told you. I was mutated and we're fleeing to the mutant city.
Can I roll insight on them?
Okay. Yeah, they're telling the truth.
Who's going to talk to Brutus?
I said Brutus, I meant Odloff. I look like that. They're being honest.
Ed and ease up on the rifle.
Alright. Well, with that though, moving out of the way, yes, Thomas and Arthur are both from the Bravo. If anyone caught the Peaky Blinders reference.
I loved it. As soon as I saw Thomas Shelby, I knew exactly what you were doing. Olaf's just going to sit beside him and be like, I don't have any vodka, I'm sorry.
Thomas is going to reach into his pack and pull out a bottle of vodka.
Olaf's going to be like, can I have a sip?
They're actually going to pass the bottle on the camp.
So they're offering some for everyone?
Yep.
Cheese and drinks.
Brutus does not.
Okay. Alright. Does Zach take a drink?
Zach passes.
Alright.
I take a sip.
So the rest of the night passes without incident. Thomas and Arthur even volunteer to take watches during the night, so you guys can get some more rest. And with that, we will move on to the next day. So, I'm going to need perception rolls as you guys wake up in the morning.
13 or 13, you take your pick.
Take the 13, Zach. Get to yours in a second. We'll see this as well. Brutus does not. Okay, so as you guys wake up, it's actually kind of clouded over. It looks like some heavy cloud cover rolled in during the night. Zach, with your 20 perception, you can tell that these clouds are close to bursting.
Close to what?
Bursting, like it's going to start raining.
Oh, okay.
That being said, as you guys start walking, I need the leader to give me their survival check for not getting lost.
I'm back.
So did I see the same thing with the 25?
Yep. Alright, Shiza manages to barely keep you guys on track. But as you guys are walking through the area, the rain starts to come down. And as you guys walk, it slowly picks up and picks up more and more until it is now a very heavy rainstorm. I'm going to need perception checks. This is hearing-based. Brutus, you hear this as well. Preach, you hear this as well. Everyone hears this, the sound of rushing water.
Oh, great.
And I need one quick survival check.
I'll roll it.
Okay. You guys are kind of in a low-lying area, and Shizu, you recognize this sound. You guys are currently about to get hit by a flash flood.
Up the hill, now.
And I start find high ground.
I'm about to purchase the high ground.
All right. So, as you guys look around, there's really not much high ground around.
Stand on the bear!
About all you guys can find as far as high ground goes are large, like, rock spires that you could hang on to. And that's about as best as you guys can do. Unless you preach.
Yeah.
Hold on to preach!
For only about 10 minutes.
I'm going to take my chances and hang on to a rock spire.
All right.
Do I have rope? Please say I have rope.
I have rope. I am going to yank at my rope and basically do a quick tie to keep myself to one of the spires as I try to hold them.
All right.
Do I need to make a roll to tie it?
No, but I want you to roll me a D100.
Oh, fuck.
Okay, so for you, those of you that are clutching onto a rock for life, Breach is just floating above you guys laughing at your misery. Alright, I need strength checks.
Oh, the one thing I fucking suck at.
Alright, Brutus. My notes are quick. Brutus, you are good. Alright, so, as the flood water, the flash flood sweeps through the area, Preach, you levitate above, so you're not affected by this. Shiza, that rope you tied, the knot was well, but you looped it over a somewhat sharper piece of the rock, and as you're hoping this rope will save your life, it snaps. And along with Olaf and Zach, you are washed away downstream.
Bye, guys.
What?
Hold on. Never mind. I can't.
I need D100s plus 25 from the three.
Can I roll a reaction to grab the rope?
You may. Roll me a dex save. You do not manage to grab the rope.
Nope, that didn't work out how I wanted it to.
How about you guys roll to grab onto Brutus?
Oh.
I should have cast this instead.
Fuck me.
Oh, that would have been perfect. We just climb up the rope.
33, sir.
Climb up the rope into an extra dimensional space.
Alright, so the flash flood kind of washes through the area. We'll get to you three in a second. I need perception check from Preach and Brutus.
Split party, huh? Here we go. Oh, Preach can see the world.
Preach, you see about 800 meters away from you guys down the plain of the floodwaters. You can see the three of them kind of sprawled out.
Yep.
Kind of like a rock. So.
All right.
So, when you go over there, let us reference the injury system.
I literally load an 8.
Oof, that's gonna suck. Roll me a D. Roll me a D2.
Lovely.
Fractured left arm. Zach, you have a major concussion. You are unconscious.
Oh, yay.
And Olaf, you broke your foot. That's it.
So my left foot.
Yep. So as Preach and Brutus come running down to you guys, that is what they come across.
Olaf's going to be like, you got a splint. My foot hurts.
Doc's gonna start working on Shiza first.
Priest is gonna be like, which one? This one, and poke his left foot.
Ow! Yes.
Okay.
Oh, well, at least we know it's the left foot.
So.
He's sure it's the left foot, he's gonna poke it again.
So.
Olaf is gonna bite his pistol.
So, Doc runs up to Shiza, and seeing the horrific injury, she's going to start working on your arm. Let me see what the first aid. Actually, I don't really need to. So she manages to get the bone and everything reset and the wound starting to heal up. However, that arm is now useless to you. So you are down to using just your pistol.
Yep. You mind if I use the barrel of the PTRD as a splint?
You don't have to. Doc has splints.
Okay.
She is a medic. She is the pad. Doc manages to wake up. that, and she gives him some painkillers for a headache, but there's really not much that he can do.
Yeah.
Alright. That being said, the flash flood kind of wiped those three people downstream. I'm going to need some D100, starting with Shiza. Roll me three D100s. Okay, you do not manage. You actually had your gear stored well enough to
push
any gear off of you. Odloff.
No. Please. One, two, three.
Some of your gear was somewhat, waterlogged or filled with some mud, so it's going to need about a good couple hours worth of maintenance next time you guys make camp to get it up and running again. Otherwise, you pretty much have a disadvantage on attacks with your guns.
Got it.
Because they're full of dirt.
Good thing Olaf very, very methodically cleans his weapons.
And Zach, three good numbers, please. You're going to hate me. I know. So, you know that M1 Grand you made?
Yeah, it's gone now, isn't it?
No, it's broken.
Oh.
You won't be able to get it functional again. Someone casts mending on it and cleans Olaf's guns for him. Nice.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
As soon as you said, yeah, your ship's waterlogged and dirty. First the digitation. Okay, never mind. It's no longer waterlogged and dirty. And your shit's broken. Mending. Your shit's no longer broken.
That's great.
I'm gonna laugh because next time we make a party, I don't know if I'm gonna give you guys spellcasters.
He's just like, fuck this. Spellcasters. Everybody's scrub.
It's not fuck this. You know, you guys are using it smart and stuff like that, but.
Yeah. Fucking Jesus.
Alright, so we're gonna
Preach
go ahead.
Just walked up. Oh man, your rifle looks pretty fucked up. There you go, bud.
I can fix that for money.
Oh man, you know what I just realized?
Huh.
All those guns that we found that are broken, I could have just fixed. We could have had a fucking armor.
Yeah, we could have. Hey, but remember that from now on.
Yeah. You found three broken. Never mind. Scratch that. You found three working.
Now I'm going to have to think of more creative ways. Yeah, you fixed it. Oh, the firing pin's still missing. Hey, man,
whoever weapon this was deserved to fucking die.
How did he even go back? I don't even. Whatever.
I'm not even going to question how he was able to shoot us.
Good on him.
He had a.
Good on him.
With a thumbtack and two. Alright, so we are going to move on. It's now the next day after the flash flood. Also, everyone spent a night soaking wet and miserable.
Except Preach.
Yeah, except Preach.
Actually, nobody spent the night soaking wet and miserable.
No, spent the night soaking wet and miserable.
It's a cantrip, so I can't spend the night
soaking wet. That being said, Zach and Brutus, you guys are going to be back at full health.
Good God.
Alright. So, I'm actually not going to do the scorpion encounter because I don't want to do it. It's going to be a waste of time combat, honestly. Get to the fun one.
Yeah.
Yeah. The fun one.
No.
And, never mind.
I guarantee it.
The equivalent of hunters.
Oh, yay.
Eagle squad.
Falcon squad?
No. So you guys have traveled through. I need one last daily set of rolls.
Here we go.
Wow, so you guys don't find good shelter. However, she's an Olaf, half 10.
I couldn't find food. Could I look for shelter as well then?
I'll give it to you. You do not find good shelter.
I don't find food.
Right. So it's the now, the next day. You guys come up on. Let me actually move your guys. Actually, there's a certain place once you guys start this fight. So you guys actually come across the abandoned Scarlet Warthog. And you can tell it is that because there are burned up Scarlet Warthog banners around the place, as well as Scarlet Warthog's bodies still on crosses from being crucified.
Nice. Das Volt.
Ish. Ish. As you guys move deeper into camp, the camp was made in like an old style manor, I guess would be a good way to describe it. You know, desert style manor with the four, you know, the full outside inside type deal. Thanks a lot. Cool. There we go.
I'm assuming this is a standard for me.
It's not so much a standard, it's like it's a building that was taken over the place and they can't.
Oh, okay.
So as you guys look through, most anything of value has been taken.
Yep.
As well as you guys find more evidence of the atrocities that have been committed here. When I say atrocities, you pretty much find, you know, like I said, crucified Scarlet Warthogs and, you know, others that look like they were tied to sticks and posts and used for target practice. One or two rooms, you literally find a Scarlet Warthog woman that was quite literally raped to death.
Mm.
So, you know, this place is just a nightmare and a travesty. Like, the raiders got raided. And it looks like it.
So, kind of like what we do in the Dark Zone and
up here. Basically.
Worse.
And the underground.
Worse.
Ugh. Okay.
As you guys explore, I'm pretty sure you guys are on this map, and you can see you guys are all kind of in this room.
Yep.
You guys walk into this room as you're exploring it. You would recognize this is probably the room where the leader would stay. And as you walk in, Shiza, you see one of your two sisters still alive, tied to a post.
Ah, a warhog, kill it!
Stop.
Joking.
I walk up to her.
I gotta remember your name.
I walk up to her. Just look at her real quick. Which one is it?
I have to look at your character real quick to tell you which one. No, you had two kids. Don't remember their name.
I had more than two.
Oh.
I think it was a Google Drive I sent you.
I don't remember your sister's name. It's been too long. The only one I remember is Feynora because Peter has her patch.
Yeah. Well, there's that again.
Let me look real quick. It is Mira?
Mira.
Mira. Mira. Yeah, she has a gag in her mouth.
I pull the gag out.
As you grab the gag, she starts shaking her head vigorously. Like, no.
Is there something I can do to inspect the gag?
Roll me a perception. don't have advantage because you can't use your skill. You see the gag, you know, is in her mouth. And you see kind of like behind you, you see like this really thin wire.
So in that case, could I use thieves' tools to disable the trap?
I mean, you may.
Okay.
So you cut the wire, and nothing happens.
I'm just reinspecting the trap.
It looks disabled.
I start to carefully... I tell everyone to please exit the room just in case something goes bad and, you know, like a bomb goes off. And then I'm going to slowly pull the gag out.
Can I roll perception on the room first?
You may. Yeah, it looks good.
I'm going to try this.
Looks good.
You know what? Might as well do the same.
Looks good.
Hold on.
Is it bad that I want to roll as well?
That looks good.
There doesn't seem to be a bomb or anything. And looking at the wire, you didn't really see what it was connected to or could really tell its purpose.
Okay, well, if I couldn't tell that, I'm going to follow the wire before I pull the gag out.
The wire goes to a place on Mira's belt.
What's on her belt?
The wire just seems to be tied to her belt.
It's tied to her belt?
Yep.
Okay, what about the other end?
It goes up into somewhere in the ceiling.
I'm gonna go check out the second deck then.
You guys are on the second deck.
Oh, well,
I'm going to point that out to him. Looks, but the wire's been cut.
And it's not like we can really call EOD.
We can call the preach.
I'm gonna locate what the item is that the wire is connected to.
Okay, so preach. You go up to the roof with anyone else?
I'll go with it.
All right, so preach and Zach. We'll get to you guys when you guys go up to the roof.
It's an old law.
Preach an old law, okay. However, Shiza.
Shiza is down there waiting for them to tell her it's okay.
All right. So as Preach and Olaf go to the roof, they see a pole up there, you know, standard, you know, a bunch of stuff on the roof, there's supplies, stuff, whatever. There's a pole, and hanging off this pole, there's like a red, you know, like the little train signal things, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
There's one of those, and it's hanging down.
Okay.
As you inspect closer, go ahead and roll me a perception. Just hanging there. All right, Preach, as you look at it, you can see the wire hanging off this thing. The wire, you can tell, has gone slack from being cut. However, if the wire was taut, the signal would be pointing up.
Okay, so it's been deactivated, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so we're good.
Yeah. Speak of the devil and he shall appear. What's up, Bill?
Are we good?
You guys are good. The trap has been disabled.
Okay, just to make sure, I'm going to destroy this train whistle.
Well, it wasn't a whistle. It was like, you know, the little paddle signal type deal, right?
I'm killing it.
All right. You destroy the paddle signal. All
right.
Push it down, yeah.
I'm still waiting for them to give me a signal that it's okay.
Okay.
All right. Alright, we're gonna come back down and go ahead and say it's okay.
I slowly pull the gag out.
As you do, your sister shakes her head more and more, and you can start to hear these, like, strange muffled ripping sounds. And as you pull the gag out, a string comes out with it covered in razor blades. And hanging off the end of the string is a note, and Temerian said, "Got you."
Damn. Wait, she's dead now?
No.
No, she is internally bleeding out because you pulled out about a 3-foot string covered in razor blades from her internal organs.
I'm going to do what I can with... to, you know... Doc?
Doc?
Doc, is there anything you can do? I'll help.
Let me roll magic. I mean, if you guys want to wait, Doc's right here.
I'm waiting for... Yeah, I'll wait.
If you want to get into this last encounter, Bill. Thought you were sick, man.
I'm fucking dying.
I thought you were, like, sick as shit. Alright, we'll wait. Yeah. This is gonna be great.
Oh, God.
Yeah?
So is this, like, the last encounter?
Yeah.
Alright, then I'm gonna get, Div up and spinning.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know how long this one's going to take.
If you said it's like Hunters, it's going to take a minute.
Yeah, it's going to take a while.
Got to go ahead and roll all of their initiatives anyway. So the reason I let you guys double look for shelter and not be going this fight with a level of exhaustion.
Yeah. I got Firecrest. I just need a pig.
Actually, you know what? Olaf can. But, you know, he's jumping in here. Never mind.
I've taken 2 entire boxes, of course.
What am I going to do? Give her my fucking cure wounds?
Yeah.
You're fucking high. I got 5 of those, and I'm probably going to eat every last one of them in this encounter.
Those only work on himself.
Oh.
Yeah, that too.
I didn't know that one.
I didn't either. But now I do.
And it kind of slipped my mind to tell you, but you've kind of used them.
Well, I mean, I would pluck one and throw it to someone if they need it, but I'm never close to anyone to give them to.
Dude, you were sick as shit. I'm like, I'd tell him he's probably, like, in bed still dying.
Yeah, just text him. I've stayed up an entire night writing.
No. All right. Playing for Doc getting it. Yeah, this is going to be a fun time. Oh, I didn't move the whole world. So you guys got to fight out of the first, the second floor.
Unless you're Brutus. Brutus, make wall. Everybody follow.
What? Oh, this is going to be a fun fight.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, pretty much. like that little trap there for you, Elsa.
What? The whole... I'm assuming the top one was a like, oh hey, they're here, an alarm one, and the other one... Although I do feel like I was trying to get that one. I was trying to focus on the one that, you know, was around the... Yeah.
There was really no way out of pulling razor blades. What's up, Doc? Pulling razor blades out of her mouth.
I know that. I walked into my trailer and heard that. A string of razor blades.
That's something great when you have a roommate like Z.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of lacerations. He's cut me before, so. Mental flashbacks.
All right. So we're going to go ahead and get initiative set up.
Alrighty. That's not where I needed to be on that.
Yeah.
Zach, remember you didn't repair your military ring yet.
Yeah, no, I'm tracking on that.
Am I leveled up at all?
No.
Ha. Amazing. Alright, let's do this.
Alright, everyone in here.
Well, I know who I'm staying close to.
Really, if I click on your roll for initiative,
it's gonna get it.
I said Bill. I don't know how you got Zach out of Bill.
Dude, I don't know. I don't know how he got me out of me. Don't worry about it.
Oh, never mind.
There we go. That's also good too. So
I'm going to go last.
All right. Before we start, I need perception rolls from everybody.
19.
I declined because I'm looking at lacerated throat.
Okay.
Can I conversely make a medical check?
You can make a medical check.
To realize that this is nothing I can do?
You can heal.
No, I can't. Medical tools or medical...
Whatever, that was medical tools.
That was a crit hit. I will take that one.
If from looking at it, her wounds and stuff internal, you would be able to save this woman if you could get to surgery in time.
What about if I use magic to keep her alive until that time?
You could be able to save her life.
Okay, I will be doing that.
Alright.
Is everyone looking away right now? Because that would be a perfect opportunity.
I mean, everyone's probably... Well, they did just pull out a note that says, got you.
Yeah, so I'm looking around to see what the fuck we got. Oh, wait, never mind. I can't read.
What?
That's right. You can't read. All right.
Go ahead and just pop that. Pop witness, should I say.
All right. So, false life. Oh, nice. All right. So, Odloff and Preach hear the sound, like very, very, you know, quiet footsteps on the roof above.
Makes sense if we just came from there.
Well, are they like right above us?
They're walking around on the roof of the building. They're very, very faint.
Like right above us?
Not right above you guys, no.
Is it anywhere in the corners of... Is it anywhere on the roof of the room that we are currently in?
No.
Damn.
Well, you're just going to point the gun up.
Yeah, just...
That's rational.
It was Og. He just wanted to sell some more stuff.
Well, bitch, you should have been sneaking around on the roof. Well, it's Zach's turn.
So. Actually, it's not Zach's turn. I just wanted initial perception. Alright.
I didn't even roll a perception. I'm an asshole.
Roll a perception.
I'll 19 take was the first one.
I'll take the 19. There. Oh. Alright. So, since Zach's next, I'll give him the perception. Zach, roll me a quick visual perception check.
Visual perception? Could I use that? 19, or was that for the original one?
That'll be for the original one.
You just roll another one.
15. So, as you look out the window to the south, you see a figure taking a knee on the ridge line just outside the thing, and as you look in a little closer, your cat eyes can tell he's about to fire a weapon. And as you look closer, you realize it's an under
feline eyes.
As you realize it's an underslung grenade launcher. I need a dex save from everybody in the room.
I have this.
What are we saving for? To not take damage from it?
Half damage.
Oh, half damage.
Can you use a dex save to attempt to slap the grenade back with a shield?
You're not in the room.
Well, I did, yeah.
No, I'm right by the door, though.
It's coming into the room.
It's coming in the room from the window to the south. You're on the north side of the room.
Oh, yeah, okay.
All right, so...
I haven't rolled yet. I have a question.
Yes?
Could I instead use it to shield Mira?
You may.
Okay. Then do I need to make a roll to shield her?
I have a question on top of that, Z.
Okay.
Could I perhaps use my reaction instead of making a dex save?
Okay.
To use shield
on
the wall.
Oh. So you're gonna? I don't understand how that would work. Visible. You know what? Yes, I will let you cast shield on the window that the grenade was gonna sort through because Zach managed to see it in time. So the grenade harmlessly explodes on the shield. But you guys now know that someone using a grenade launcher has your guys' position pinned.
Oh, I was like, I want that thing, but let's kill him first.
That's very generous.
It is now Zach's turn. It was very generous because if he didn't pass the save, you were taking 25 damage.
Oh, that would have been like a D100 plus 3400.
Zach, do that.
Fuck. I'm going to fuck out of this room.
Alright.
God, I hate it when it's like this.
It's like what?
It's like 0.4, 0.5.
Okay.
Let me... I'm just going to keep my rifle trained down this way for now.
Gotcha. All right. This guy's turn. Okay. Odlaw, you have 3/4 cover against this, by the way.
Okay, so that gives me what, a plus 6?
9.
9? Okay.
Does a 27 hit?
Yes.
6 damage. And if you got body armor, make sure to remember that.
Do I have body armor?
Wow, you guys could have had so much body armor, too. Preach, you realize how much body armor you could have had everyone get?
What do you mean?
Mend the broken body armor.
Oh. Oh, shit. I mean... yeah, fuck! Oh, well, we know that now.
Yes, we do.
Oh, God, so I don't even have to really repair it. I don't have to get my armor repaired. I can repair it myself.
Is mending an action?
Mending is...
an action.
Yeah.
I guess technically in the middle of combat, if you don't have anything else to do, you could repair your armor right there.
Yeah, just poof. There we go.
It seems kind of stressful.
Yeah. All right. So, Olaf, you take... Ah, that's true.
Ah, fuck.
We'll say you...
I took 6. I got it.
Reach. It's now your turn.
My turn?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so where's this fucker to the south?
Out the window. You'd have to roll perception to see him. You don't see him. Actually, hang on. I'll roll his stealth. If he's there. Yeah, you don't see him.
Okay. Well, I mean, he did shoot a fucking grenade launcher, so...
Even if I gave him disadvantage, you still didn't see him.
Very well then. Well, in that case, I'm going to pop my armor booster.
There you go.
So I get that plus 10 to on top of my 8. And I don't see anybody else outside the window, do I?
No.
Alright. Well, then I'm going to boogie out the room, run this way, past the bear, and I'm going to use my other action to come into this room right here. Wait, all right. Because I'm taking these stairs lead up to the roof.
Those ones do lead up to the roof.
Alright, I'm gonna post with my back, well, I'm gonna be posted looking at the door.
Gotcha. Alright. It's Peter's turn.
Peter? So
Peter's going to... He's gonna move with Zach. He's gonna try to cover Zach. He's actually gonna go in this room. Alright. I gotta see where this guy's at. Action. Doc, it's your turn.
Alright, is this person still in the room?
Yeah.
She's tied up.
Yeah, she's tied up.
Oh, was it blood pie, right? Running.
No, she was, like, tied to a post.
She's tied to a post?
Yeah. There's, like, blood trickling out of her mouth.
Out of her mouth, huh? I did that thing we talked about.
Very well.
I assume there was a proper time when shit was hitting, window. As far as this post, can I try to break the post?
Yeah, I mean, you could spend your turn, you could spend an action to cut her bonds.
Yeah, I'll do that, and then I'll try to, I'll aid whoever, probably Shiza or Olaf, to get him, her out of the room. Like, let me show you.
Shiza's got a broken arm.
Yeah,
by the way.
Yeah.
Alright.
She looks stable for now, but I'm gonna put her, like, right outside the room.
Okay.
In the cover. Yep.
Brutus.
Okay. So, that shooter came from the south, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is this a window right here?
Yeah.
The quickest way between 2 points?
A point.
Great line.
I don't know that you can fit out that window.
Brutus is going to run and jump through that window.
You're not fitting through that window.
Okay.
Full speed, ram it!
Does my 900 pounds take out the wall?
I mean, it makes the whole building shake, but that's about it.
But no hole?
No.
Okay.
If you used your combat rig...
Nah, the athletic rig?
Yeah, that's what it was.
So it goes down. You're going down him right now.
I mean the door.
The door to the first floor?
No, the door out of this courtyard.
I mean, I'd actually have to go back to the map layer and move the whole world for that.
Okay, the goal is to get on the outside of the building.
Okay. In that case...
This one to, like, the GM layer.
The way out looks...
It looks like it's through here.
Yeah, pretty much take a loop around the stairs and go out that way.
A few exits.
There's a couple entrances. Yeah, the barn.
Alright, back to where we were.
Through this way.
Yep.
There we go. That's 40.
We'll call that good. Alright, she's a...
Okay, what would it take to pull my scope? Can I roll to see which would be easier, pulling my scope or pulling my rifle? To look through my scope.
You're... With one arm, you probably won't be able to support the weapon enough to actually really use the scope to its full effectiveness. You could technically use the window as a brace.
Yeah.
Like use it with one hand.
Okay, I'm gonna go up there and do that.
Alright.
And
I guess perception?
Yep. 26.
You actually see both of these guys on the ridge to the south.
Olaf, I see them.
Okay.
What is that? 5 and 4:30?
Yeah, like that. All right.
Is she's calling that out?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sweet.
The elusive sandwich.
Yeah. And
Alright.
And then with that, I'm going to try to stealth with my action. An 8's not good.
And Achilles 2 doesn't work in the building.
Nope. Oh, so 5.
Alright. And no loft, it's actually not your turn.
Okay.
Back.
Alright.
Welcome back.
Take one shot at Zach. Zach, you don't have cover against this, I'm pretty sure. But he missed. So, doesn't matter. However, you don't hear a gunshot, but suddenly you hear a thud as a crossbow bolt narrowly misses your face and embeds itself in the wall.
Shit.
There's other ones.
Right. Going there, and he's going to take a shot at Doc.
You don't see me
get fucked.
Alright, Doc, I need a con save.
I'm back.
I'm back.
Oh, my drugs. Ooh. Dun.
You take 9 damage, 3 piercing, 6 poison.
Okay. 39.
And here's this guy.
Well, there's a lot of people around before me.
Uh-huh.
Do I get a perception check on that dude who shot me?
You do get a perception check. You'd like one.
No, fuck you. I'm kidding. I'm going to take that perception check. Please don't. Please don't shoot me again.
You don't know. You don't know where it came from.
Because if you don't know, then you know.
All right. This one's against Zach. Wow, Zach, you're lucky. You just missed again, but another crossbow bolt just buried itself in a wall near you. You can roll perception.
Yeah, I'm going to do that. No, I'm good.
You don't know where it came from.
I didn't even see the crossbow bolt.
What? Bending over, getting a fucking arrow shot in the wall?
Odloff, it's your turn.
Oh, thank God.
Oh, look, it's a penny. Thunk. What was that?
This is a weird wall decoration.
Was someone putting...
Okay, Z, from here, I'm going to try to, like, fucking ninja assassin the shit and climb and hold myself up against the corner of the wall.
Roll me in athletics.
Aye, aye.
No, you don't manage to do that.
Whatever, I'll take the stealth.
And you stealth.
I rather have something. There's people firing every which way.
Well, you don't know that those shots happened.
No, but I know about the fucking explosive bullshit.
This guy doesn't know Olaf's there.
Did I get shot with the crossbow bolt?
Yeah.
I would have yelled at, ah, fuck, I got shot by a crossbow bolt.
Oh, fair enough. Alright, so this guy, since he doesn't know Olaf's there, he swings off the roof, like ninja assassin. And lands on the balcony.
Oh my god, fuck him. Not in the ass. I mean, in the ass with a...
Oh, man.
Fuck.
He only gets to make one attack, though. I don't think it's...
Not the hole.
Yeah, you're good.
What did you roll?
Not above a 14.
Fair enough. My armor class is undefeatable.
Alright. Now I gotta find this... Gentlemen. All right. Bruce is about to not like me. All right.
Perception to see from whom?
You may roll perception as you get shot in the back by this gentleman.
Hey, Z, just heads up. I got an exotics marksman rifle just now.
What'd you get?
The Tenon Bear.
Oh, okay.
The Tenon Beret or whatever.
Nice.
All right. So.
I'm facing him.
He still got shot. It's his turn.
I don't see that guy.
He's on a different layer. Oh, I see him now. I see him. Never mind. Gotcha. Too much going on.
Zach, roll me a quick perception with advantage.
Perception with advantage.
Yeah,
good.
Nope,
I'm good, guys.
You're good. Okay. That's gonna hit. You take 16 damage.
Good God.
And as you feel a knife drive itself into your back, and you turn around and you see all this dude.
He's still invisible.
This guy.
I think that's an injury too, isn't it?
What's that gonna be? 1d100 plus.
Just a d100.
Right, no, that's just a d100.
It looks like a pretty light. What'd you get?
47.
I don't know how it happened, but he managed to dislocate one of your arms.
Good. Is there another one near it that makes more sense?
Bleeding wound. Take an additional additional 1d8 bleed until you take care of it.
I mean, I'd rather do that than a fucking broken arm. All right. I mean, that's just not realistic.
So on his next turn, you'll take a bleed. Unless you fix it, or Doc fixes it.
I appreciate losing blood for the sport of it.
I'll take that over. Oh, I stabbed you in the back and your arm is broken.
It fits continuity to me.
Alright, she's
Let me guess. One of these two?
Nope. Oh yeah, one of those two? Yes. Oof. Oof. You're not gonna like that.
Do I have any cover?
Yeah, I mean, you have plus 9.
Plus 9?
Yeah. Make your AC 25. Yep. So this is only one attack. Only one attack hits you. Because you're looking right at him, I'll let you roll a dex save for half. You only take 11 damage as a massive burst of machine gun fire peppers the window and around rips across your cheek. Should have blown your face off.
Damn.
Yeah, it was a crit.
Oh!
In fact, you rolled 2 crits, but the second one wouldn't have hit you.
Ugh!
Zach, it is your turn. This guy just stabbed you in the kidney. What you gonna do about it?
Fucking.
Yeah, I got skills.
Stab him with bullets.
That was close.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I'm gonna stab him 3 times with bullets.
Alright. all 3 of those hit, but you are at close range, so you actually have disadvantage, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Still a hit, actually. Pretty sure. Yeah, all those still hit. 14,
38, 39.
He looks a lot worse for wear, but he's still up. Where's this guy at? Okay, he's the other guy. Yeah. Alright, Cheesa, you still have cover against this.
Since I'm disappointed in all of us and nobody's done it. It's a trap!
doesn't matter.
What?
He jammed.
It doesn't matter if he jammed.
Oh. How do you jam a crossbow?
It's not a crossbow.
It's probably a machine gun or a grenade launcher or maybe a sniper.
There's a sniper. He jammed on a crit, so you're lucky.
Oh.
Maybe it's an erector set.
Definitely an erector set. Thanks.
It's giving me an erector. What?
Get out of this trailer.
Come on, this is the perfect place to sit. That.
Preach, it's your turn.
Maybe I shouldn't have screamed out their position.
Alright,
Well, you do know one of those two has the grenade launcher.
Yeah, but full auto is a full round action, so I can't do that.
I mean, I'm looking at it right now, you could get one of them.
I was actually gonna pop out the door and get. Oh, whoa, yeah.
you can get that guy.
Yeah, I'm gonna go for it. First, I'm gonna use my bonus action to cast magic weapon to give me a plus 1 to my attack.
Alright.
And then I'm going to go for that one dude with the stinger.
Are you shoulder firing it? Yeah, it would have to be.
Yeah, it's gonna have to be, so.
Alright. Because you're shooting through that window, he has 3 quarters cover.
Alrighty.
Fucking hell. Alright,
2 crits.
So. He didn't catch. He had three quarters cover, so only the first round really gets to the window and finds purchase. But damn, if that was a first
crit
round.
21 doesn't get.
No, it doesn't hit the AC still.
Wow. Okay.
No, well, a crit's an automatic hit. He just doesn't get the crit bonus.
Doing something different with it.
Yeah. It's still a whopping fucking 25 damage off one bullet, though.
26.
Oh, 26.
Oh, wait, doesn't he also get a plus one for being a magic weapon?
Yeah, that's what he's counting.
Oh,
yeah,
it's already counting.
Yeah, it's already counting. It's already counted in.
So that guy takes a solid round in the upper chest. Alright, Peter.
And.
Sorry.
Yeah, never mind, you're good.
That's right, you did use your bonus.
Yep.
This guy, so Peter doesn't like Zach getting shot like that, so Peter's gonna come out here, draw his Webley.
And gets like six shots with it.
He does the hammer pair. You can basically empty that whole chamber. Alright. That one hits. So that guy in front of Zach, he hears you pull that.
Oh, thank God.
Finally, turn.
Peter, do it diving into the courtyard. That'd be badass.
Yeah, until Peter has to roll for injury by breaking his fucking shoulder.
Not if he's amazing.
Doc, it's your turn.
I was gonna say, isn't it my turn?
Yeah.
He's going to kill me. Let me check one thing real quick. What does the tritium do?
It gives you a plus one.
Thank you.
But you are, it's already all in your weapon calculation, man.
Yeah, I know. I was just checking. I wasn't sure. Sorry. The tactics one more time. I can do. Can I do semi-auto burst? Is that a tactic?
No, but you could do a failure to stop drill.
Okay. What is that? Two attacks? Or
failure to stop. I think you only have access to.
I have tactics too.
So yeah, failure to stop. Full round action.
Go ahead. Yep. Or so actually, here, I'll just pop it for you.
Yep.
Ah, cool.
So.
Okay.
Roll me the attack. That hits. Roll me three damage rolls.
Oops.
That's 11, 13. So, 33.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Alright, and now he has to roll a con save equal to half of 33, which would be like 17.
Half of 33 is, yeah.
Doesn't matter, he is now knocked prone.
Oh, is he?
He rolled a three.
Good.
And he's crippled for
1d4 yep. rounds.
1d4. Crippled for three rounds.
Wait, hold on. Oh, that was 17. Damn it.
All right. Good job, Doc.
Yeah.
Brutus.
Why is it to my damage?
Yep. Dude. I'm gonna move up here.
I'll take your hold.
The prone?
No, he's standing up.
Thank you.
Okay, nothing's happening. That is actually a swing and a miss. And he deck saves on it.
Okay, then I would like to hit him with the shield and attempt to knock him off. Oh, he rolled away. Son of a bitch.
Yeah. When I said this is like fighting hunters, these guys have reactions.
It's oh, great.
Okay.
So he's over there now.
I would like to tackle him.
Roll me an attack then.
A strength, or what do you want?
You're trying to tackle him, so it'd be strength. So, wow. The mouse is lucky. Alright, so here's there. You go to tackle him, and he sidesteps you.
Seriously?
Yes.
Welcome to Fighting Hunters, bud.
Jeez, your turn.
So with it, with my weapon being in the window, I can basically use it like normal?
Yes.
Okay. Sighting in and going to try to hide better.
All right.
Swapping seven.
Oh, solid seven. This guy, yeah. All right. So this guy. All right. Does he know where the automatic car came from? Drop down here. Doc, you guys will be able to see this guy. So I'm just going to drop him. And Preach.
Yo.
I gotta find where it is. Alright. I'm going. You need to roll me a deck save. Alright, so he tosses something in the room and you manage to cover, you know, look away just in time as a flashbang goes off.
Very well.
Not getting flashbang off. Alright. This guy here. Olaf's still hiding in that room, isn't he?
You damn right I am.
What was your last stealth?
23. Well, it's okay, because if you try to sneak attack me, I cannot be surprised within 50 meters.
Yeah, I know. He has a swing down here, so you guys can see him.
Oh, thank God.
He's stabbing Peter.
Oh, poor Pete.
Pete takes seven. Also trying to get all of them on the freaking token layer. It makes my life easier. And this last guy is going to shoot
Pete got busted, didn't he?
No. No, that'd be worse than that.
Oh. Damn hunters.
Pretty much. Got a map real quick, I'm sorry. I'm not good at quick.
One plus one. It's two. Quick maths.
God, shut the fuck up.
Thanks, Bill.
Bill, I've missed you.
What's up, guys? Sorry, I've been dying.
That's what Z said.
Well, die fast.
That's what I'm saying, right?
Peter just takes
in hell.
Peter takes a whopping 23 damage.
Jesus Christ.
Oh. As the crossbow bolt hits him hard. Rolls for injury.
In the dick.
In the dick.
I was told that NPCs didn't get hurt.
James isn't coming back to the game, so if Peter dies, Peter dies.
Oh. If he dies, he dies.
So Zach, you turn around and you see Peter get stabbed, and then a cross. There's no way for a crossbow to amputate someone's leg. So this is going to be bad enough. It goes straight through his thigh,
and by the sudden spray of blood, you can tell that his femoral artery was just severed.
Mm. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. He was only 6 points away from death. Great death.
He's not dead yet.
Not yet. No, he's not. On his next turn, he takes 1d12 bleed.
Mm.
Oh, Olaf, it's your turn.
I have a turn before him.
All right.
That guy can't take it. He kind of blew his hip out of joint.
Shove and shoot.
That hits. Roll me the two damage rolls.
Mediocre.
T.I.
What are you, Morton Joe now?
He will take the attack, but
you shall arrive, shiny and crow.
Does a 17 hit you?
By one, yeah.
You take 11 slashing damage as you shove and shoot him with a shotgun, which doesn't really seem to phase him, and he slashes you with a knife.
Good to go.
Yep. All right, and there's this guy. He can't do much. He's kind of out for the count for about the next two rounds. Considering Doc did harm instead of do no harm.
I did not take the...
Socratic Oath.
Yeah, the Hippocratic Oath.
Hippocratic Oath.
All right. I think that's a bad nerve.
Now it's this guy's turn, who's dancing with the devil. All right, and he is going to do this.
Nice try, American spy.
I need a dex save from Brutus.
Brutus don't dex well.
Brutus
this
guy
does not dex well.
He is not a dancing bear. He is Russian war bear.
You don't get a dex save against... Well, you fail the dex save against it, so you don't get an attack of opportunity. As this guy dives out of the way, as you see him dive, you look down just in time to take full to the face a flashbang grenade. You are blind for two rounds.
Okay.
That's a good marker for blind. it's this guy's turn.
The one that almost took my face off.
Elsa,
yeah.
I will give you a deck save against this because you're looking right at them. You see him get up from prone again, taking a knee, and you recognize action from last time. So deck
going
save.
Flat.
For half.
24.
Alright. You take 10 damage as nope, it's behind you.
Oh damn, I was gonna dive under that. Good thing I didn't.
No, it's a good thing you did not. I guess that would make sense with the concussion wave. One of your legs, one of like your knees has been pretty much shattered. So your right knee has been shattered as shrapnel and the force of the explosion kind of take it. Ouchie.
What, I can't move anymore?
Basically, yeah, you're stuck there.
Yep.
So, wait, I'm on the ground now, underneath. Right?
Yeah. I mean, you can roll a con to grit your teeth and get back up.
Yeah, it's not my
fire.
Turn.
I know. All right, Zach, it's your turn, though.
I guess I'm gonna go... Motherfucker.
All right. Yeah, blast him. Roll me three damage rolls, please.
I forgot my DR.
Go ahead and apply.
Both of them?
Yep.
Uh, A, I wouldn't take that injury.
And forget the injury. You have DR. Remember your DR. Really helpful. All right, let's see if this guy jams his gun.
Oh, yeah, I do have DR.
I do, too.
DR to that nice attack? Oh, no, I didn't for that knife attack.
He does unjam his gun. He...
Unjamming is a full action.
Yep. Thank you, Cal. Because he knew who he was probably about to shoot.
Yeah, it's a machine gun versus machine gun right now.
No, he's the one with the DM rifle.
Oh, yeah, no, fuck this guy.
Alright, now it's Preach's turn.
So, if I lay down, will I still be able to shoot through this window?
No. I mean, you could take a knee and get better cover from and shoot out the window.
Yeah, I'm going to do that. Right. It's still going to be without the bipod, so...
Yep. Assault rifle attack, then.
Jesus.
None of it.
Fuck!
None of it comes even close enough to give him suppression.
Okay, whatever.
I mean, I just would have moved to the window.
If I move, it's not a full...
You have other weapons. You are like a walking armory, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, but that's the one that I get the most damage with.
True.
Consecutively.
Now she's in the window.
But I am going to use my bonus action to Misty Step to the window, though. Oh, you know
there
what?
We go.
I'm just going to use my bonus action, Misty Step to the window, and then...
Then shoot him?
Fuck.
There we go. Okay.
I jammed anyways.
Ouch. At least you're at the window now.
Yeah.
Well, Peter.
It is Peter's turn. Peter is gonna takes 8 more bleed.
Ugh.
Not dead yet.
He's actually at 2 health.
Oh my god.
Pete's laying there. He's bleeding out, but he will reach in his pack and he will apply. He'll kind of crawl into here. And he'll put a tourniquet on his leg, stop the bleeding. But he's pretty much out of the fight.
Smart. And he's getting off the X.
Pretty much out of the fight, though. Kind of hard to stay in the fight when you get your femoral artery severed.
Nah, bitch, if you die, and you die in a pile of brass.
That kind of pain is all in your head. That's all head pain. You just work through it.
That's all head pain.
It's mental. It's mental. You gotta work through it.
Yeah,
no hand, work through it.
No pain, no gain.
Yeah.
Doc, your turn.
Mama right. Didn't raise no bitch.
Seeing everyone get shot, I'm going to roll this. Smit. Whoop. 15 to everyone. And I actually didn't check to see if Peter's still in range. He's not. Hilarious. Everyone else is in range except for Brutus. And Peter. You can go die, Peter. I tried.
Zach's bleeding wound is also gone.
Back too bad I don't need any of that.
Two less would have been is what I needed. So.
And then yep. And actually thinking better of that now. Dun-dun-dun. Bam. I'm gonna run back.
Please say that you're dragging
yes.
Girl
yeah.
with you.
Yeah. She's not a very strong woman, but she can drag people.
Yeah, you're dragging her now.
Get back!
Alright, Brutus. It is your turn. You are blind.
Just start swinging, baby.
Pick a direction and charge.
Nope, I was looking for something and I found it.
What's up?
Bears have great sense of smell.
Scent. You gave me the scent ability.
Roll me a scent then.
I don't have to. It says a creature within the scent ability can detect opponents by sense of smell. Generally,
within 30 feet. If the opponent is upwind, the range is 60 feet. If downwind, the range is 15 feet, and he is within 15 feet of me.
Yep, you know where he is.
Charge.
You thought you could get away? You thought you could get away from the Russian war bear?
You thought I was a regular bear? No, I am a Russian war bear.
Suck up, yeah!
Roll me a strength. Roll me an attack then. Charge.
Say goodbye to your fascist balls.
Alright, so I'm moving your character for you. You charge to this guy. He critted his deck save, so. Pulled out of the way.
Yeah, you have that 100 that we all hate.
Yes, you do. Jesus, your turn.
Alright, so, I sighted it.
Get to charge him again.
You moved, second attack. You moved and made an attack.
Alright.
You're also blind, so.
Alright.
I could have been a real dick and had him trip you on that.
Alright, so I sighted in, and the one that's been giving me so much grief.
Alright.
30.
You hit.
14.
You don't get sneak attack. You guys kind of know where each other are.
Yeah, fair enough. 7.
Alright.
Reload, and I'm going to see if I can try to hide better.
Alright.
Wait, could I take full cover by just laying down?
Yes, you could.
doing that. And can I also roll stealth as a bonus?
You may. Try to crawl. Alright, this guy is not crippled. But he is. Alright. So, this guy.
Yep.
Oh boy. Alright, so this guy, he pulls his you can see it's not a crossbow, it's actually a Helsing.
Oh, okay, cool.
And he shoots at Odloff.
Yep. Unless he has crossbow feet, it better be at disadvantage.
Yeah, with disadvantage he still hits.
Okay, can I have reaction and drop my bubble shield?
I mean, he'd be in it.
That is true. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, like, what's up, bud? We're going to be doing this for a minute, okay? Okay. All right.
Roll me a con save.
All right. So I'm going to fuck this con save. Oh, yeah. I'm going to.
You save. You only take 5 damage, only 4 of it being poison.
Nice.
All right.
I got something for his ass.
You hear him? Get the healer.
No, I'm not a
heal. Olaf's going to be like, what the fuck are you talking about? You better be worried about me.
All right, so the other guy that's over there.
That's still prone? Oh, never mind.
Not the guy that's crippled. He's kind of out till next round. He's going to go over here and take cover in that room.
Oh.
Firing off a bolt at Olaf.
Yeah, of course.
That, I think it hits 16.
Oh, that matches. That hits.
Roll me a con save. You failed. 13 damage.
Don't forget DR, bud.
Oh, you're right. That doesn't count. Never mind. So that 5 did not do nothing to me.
Poison does, though.
The poison does. So, and then that was 13.
Peter got fucked up.
Appreciate it, fucking co. Only took 8. Okay. 43.
Work hard. Alright, now it's this guy's turn. Alright. Zach. Miss. Doesn't matter.
Cheeky Breaky, who posted that amazing?
Me. Cheeky Breaky!
Cheeky Breaky.
Sorry.
Olaf, it's your turn.
If you scroll up, you'll see more Slavic hard base and shit, too.
Oh, man, I love that shit.
I'm back.
It's so good.
All right.
Nice try, American spy.
American pig dog in your capitalism.
Actually, he does exceed your attack. So you pull up the justifier, and this guy dives into this room. And he just hit the wall.
Idiot.
This guy's crippled for the next round. I'm going to take it off.
Hold on. I'm going to shoot the other dude with the fucking judge. It's laying on the ground.
Okay. Shoot him.
Yeah, fuck that guy.
Roll me the damage.
10. 11.
Okay, just stop. If you're using Flechette, this guy's dead.
Yeah, I'm using Flechette and the judge.
This guy's fucking done.
Yeah.
What was once a man now is a pile of ground beef.
Is he even a pile? Just stringy pieces?
Pretty much, yeah. That's like I said, ground beef. I mean, you look at ground beef, it's pretty stringy. All right.
And I'm going to take a knee behind this little rail.
All right. This guy does not like getting shot at by or charged at by Brutus.
Too bad, bitch. You're going to keep getting charged.
He's going to run straight up here. And he's going to ready an action, but that's his turn. Alright, it's now this guy's turn. He's had enough of this bullshit. So, he reloads the breech. And he's firing at Preach.
Alright. I'll be right back.
Hey, Z, bubble shield.
Alright. So you drop the bubble shield, and a grenade goes off on the bubble shield. I gotta drop the bubble shield for you, don't I?
Yeah.
Was it a 10 foot radius?
I don't fucking remember, dude. I think so. Yo, I've been on point with these shields, dude.
They're keeping you alive, I'll tell you that.
Oh shit, I have bubble shields. I forgot about that entirely.
Alright, it's like when you forget about your support station.
Yep.
You forget, like, you can, take a water or canned food or
something like that. Zach, it's your turn.
I'm back.
Now, I can't shoot out of this thing, correct?
Yes, you can. You
can shoot out, but not in. Nothing can enter, but things can leave.
Oh, good. This will give me a minute to, reload my shit.
This guy is gonna fucking get his.
Alright.
Spadunk. Just the first one.
Alright. He doesn't manage to get his reaction to go off. Won't be the damage.
Don't watch that video if you have a very loud volume on your computer.
Was that just one shot?
Yeah, because I moved, so I could only do one.
All right, here he is. Where's this guy at? Here's the other guy down here. It is the other guy who unjammed his rifle.
Kamazar Brutus.
So he's actually going to boogie out and go help his buddy.
Work harder, comrade.
And then he fires at Brutus. Brutus, take 10 damage. Alright. Brutus. Brutus. Brutus.
Sorry.
Did you hear my last?
Yeah, 10 damage.
Gotcha. Breach.
Yes, sir. Oh, my turn. What is it to fix a weapon?
It is a dex.
Dex?
Yep.
Dex save, dex what?
Dex check. Bonus shield. Shield the bubble shield.
Oh my god.
Bubble shield now has plus 5 to its AC. What?
Nah, that's it. That's all.
Alright. Doc.
Alright. I'm gonna lean out.
Alright.
Alt. Alt. But I have to hold alt down. There we go. And I'm going to do that shooting thing again. That one drill.
Alright. Player to stop drill. Roll me an attack.
Yeah, I'll be shooting Thugnificent on the stairwell.
Alright, go ahead and roll.
Alright. Let's do this. 19.
Yeah. Yeah, roll me the 3 damage. That's actually a... No, you didn't roll a 19. You rolled a 19. You didn't roll a 19.
That wasn't base, yeah.
Okay. I was like, oh, great. Alright.
That's poopy.
369. Dang, you fine.
And he... 369. Wow, that's...
Hey, you wanna go die somewhere else?
Please don't die in the trailer. And he passes his con save. Brutus, it's your turn.
Which way is the wind blowing?
It's been 2 rounds. I don't think you're blinded anymore.
Okay, then. Time for the athletic rig.
Okay, go ahead.
Turning it on.
All right.
I'm going to sprint to this one.
Back up.
Gotcha. Is that a bubble shield?
Yeah, it is.
It is a bubble shield, Brutus. Come on. There we
Can
go.
Can I see the bubble shield?
Well, he was readying it for when you charged again, because he knew you would charge again. So, as right as you charge, he drops it, and you run into the bubble shield, which is like hitting a wall.
Okay, but the shield was up, so 2 immovable objects.
Yeah. So, but I need you to roll damage.
An immovable object and an unstoppable force.
I need you to roll me damage. roll me, what is it, 2d6 we had for your charge? I think we just need to make that a thing on your sheet now. The Brutus charge.
Yeah.
Plus strength.
Yeah. Yeah, 2d6 plus 7, please.
Okay.
Your strength is 7? What the fuck?
Brutus can technically wrestle a deathclaw. Actually, he did wrestle a deathclaw.
I was going to say, technically, he did it.
He is a deathclaw.
And a purple worm.
Alright, so the shield takes 12 damage. The bubble shields only have 100.
100 HP.
Brutus, you take 6 damage as you crunch your shoulder into this solid and you can almost swear you see a smirk on that Legion guy's face.
Oh, Legion.
How long do bubble shields last?
Till you deplenish HP of 100.
10 rounds or till the HP is gone.
Can he shoot out of it?
Yes.
Yes, he can.
Okay. Well, the shield is implanted in front of him, so.
Yeah. Jesus, your turn.
Alright. So, half my movement, stand up.
Yep.
Perception as a bonus action.
Alright.
Without the scope.
You get home, girl.
Yeah, is this guy still. Can I still see this guy?
Well, I mean, he has. Yeah, you can still see him. You have to try to re up stealth or anything.
Okay.
Out
you're doing Decepticon stuff.
Yeah.
What are you doing that with?
I think she's setting.
Pulling out my pistol.
What's the range of your pistol?
I imagine it goes 35 feet.
No, that doesn't hit anyway.
Yeah. Well, I still got the second attack, right?
Yes.
And then I lay back down.
Lay back down?
Yep.
Calling it a day there, huh?
Just popped up, try to get some pop shots off. Not working in my favor.
Alright, so this gentleman, he's going to retreat upstairs and come back out on the roof. And he comes back out on the roof. He is going to take a shot at Zach.
Of course he is.
18?
Matches.
Con save.
Give me one sec. Con.
You pass. So you're going to take 4 piercing, 5 poison.
Good God.
Good God, man.
All right. So, Zach, you can go ahead and use a reaction.
Would I be able to use my reaction to stroke him? Because he's like right there.
Yep, go ahead and roll me a melee attack.
Yeah, claw for it.
Ooh, you missed. So, you take 8 slashing damage as he knifes you.
Yeah, I'm getting fucked up here. That's definitely another injury.
Probably gonna be, what, plus 20?
Oh.
Wow. Oh. Wow. A 28 net to you. A broken hand.
Which makes perfect sense.
Wait, which one?
Roll me a D2.
Hand.
Left hand.
My left hand's robotic.
Fritzy.
It's Fritzy. It's going on the friends.
Yep. Damage your left hand.
Oh, gotcha.
This guy seeing that Zach's well in order. He's coming over here. And he's actually going to go ahead and drop down to that balcony so you guys can see him. Feel him. Alright, and he drops down there. And I think that's out of range for his weapon.
And I'm hiding behind this little rail system.
Olaf.
I'm dropping my bubble shield.
Okay.
And then I am firing at old fuckface that just fell down.
I'm firing my laser, huh?
I'm a fire my laser!
Meme it. Someone meme that or I will.
I'd have to find it.
Thank you.
And you will hit once.
Yeah, I figured as much. For 4.
All right.
Too late.
Damn it.
Marcus, So this guy, you see him sling his rifle, he draws his pistol, and he draws a tomahawk.
Ooh, I want that.
He looks at Brutus and hears him say, "Let's dance, fat man."
Could you ping that guy for me?
He's the
seen one last time before he died.
Give me one second.
Can I respond?
I mean, yeah, you feel free.
Brutus is gonna step back and drop his shotgun.
Okay.
He's gonna pull his cleaver.
Good.
I just heard tomahawk, and I was like, that's really something I would need.
Yep.
Oh, if I kill him, I am so keep eating a tomahawk.
Oh, I figured you would. I'm not even going to argue that one with you.
Trick him into hitting you with it, then you can just kill him. It's not coming out.
Alright. Where is this guy? So this guy's down here. Going to Elsa. Deck save. Deck save for half. You don't pass the deck save.
Fitting, because I'm prone.
You take 21 explosive damage.
Does my armor protect from any of it?
I mean, yeah.
So.
Alright. Is that an injury?
Just fucking barely.
What was your previous injury?
Broken arm.
Oh,
you mean the one that didn't count? That was the broken leg.
Okay, but you do have that compound fracture. So, roll for injury plus 15.
Plus 15?
68. Broken arm.
Let me guess, now it's my other arm.
Yes.
Yeah.
You have
to make a con save to use that arm. Had a rough.
The other one was a shattered arm joint. This one's a broken arm.
It was a shattered leg joint. It was a shattered leg joint. Your other arm's a compound fracture.
No, the leg one didn't count. It didn't count.
I know.
But I have the shattered arm joint from the fucking flood.
Yep. Zach, it's your turn.
Or no, it was a compound fracture. My bad.
Yeah.
Full diddle.
All right, roll it.
Pickle in his piddle.
Oh boy. All of that, even at the disadvantage, still hits. And hits for quite a bit.
20.
All right. He looks pretty fucked up.
Fuck that guy.
I'm just picturing from, I can't remember what movie it is, where the guy's got two arrows in his leg.
Ace Ventura.
That's Elsa right now. Brutus.
So I'm going to go ahead and...
It's not your turn. You're taking 7 damage.
From where?
The guy behind you.
Behind you.
I'm trying to have a duel here.
They don't care about that.
They don't fucking care about that shit.
They're hunters.
They're hunters. They don't give a fuck. I'm surprised they ain't. Never mind.
Yeah, you shut up.
Yeah. Never mind.
You shut up.
No, don't worry. They'll get worse.
Oh, I know.
We're just going to be walking one day and all of of a sudden we're gonna hear son of a bitch.
Yup.
Alright. And these guys have their ready to action.
Kyle, you know what it's gonna be?
Alright. I need a deck save from Olaf. And
a dex.
I need a deck save from Olaf and Doc.
Mother trucker. Actually, deck save is good. Watch it. Never mind.
Doc, you need to get to a window close to me so you can heal me.
Alright.
I was trying. I haven't had a turn in forever.
Doc, you are blinded for 2 rounds.
Why would Olaf have to make a deck save?
He's looking at the...
I can still see without sound. I mean, without my eyes.
So you guys see 3 flash in the courtyard. These guys to the proper lair, finally. Fucking maneuver element.
Oh, of course. Of course they were.
Yep. You were warned. These guys are really smart. It's their turn to breach. In there, so preach your turn though.
All right, well, I'm pivoting and lighting this dude up.
Which
this guy?
Oh, that guy. Okay. Yeah. Oh good god, that all hits.
He gets it all, motherfucker.
Pretty much, if you're getting shot up by a machine gun, you should just be in full cover. Just take the suppression. Yeah, he's probably, yeah, he's dead. So there's
how long grenade.
Yeah. Even with the DR.
His body.
Even with the DR, he's dead. And this guy, now his turn, he sees Olaf's bubble shield. He don't like that. Two rounds, Bill.
Alright.
Olaf, you see your bubble shield get hit by a grenade and it starts to crack.
Okay. How much HP do you take away from it?
21.
Okay.
Doc, it is your turn.
I'm going to inch my way back inside whilst grabbing the body under my feet. And I'm going to take my whole turn to try and maneuver into the corner. Pointing my gun at the door if I hear things. I might just unload.
For the fuck of it.
Yeah.
Pull your load.
Nobody else walk in. I will use the rest of my bullets.
All right. I'll
fire my laser.
Brutus, it is your turn.
I'm going to take this turn to walk to the other side of this bubble shield.
All right.
That way that asshole can't keep shooting me in the back. And then I'm going to take painkillers.
Alright.
Grab those. And how much health does that add?
I'm about to go look at what painkillers do for you. Painkillers. You get 10 of your HP back. Wonder if anyone's got stim packs.
I do.
I do.
What do you?
I actually have some of those. I was wondering. Is that as well? With that?
You can use. You moved, so you can use one or the other.
How much does Stimpak give me?
A Stimpak will give you 1d10 plus 5.
I'm gonna take the painkillers for now. And I'm waiting for this guy to drop his bubble shield.
Alright, so you get 10 HP back. Alright. Tiza, it's your turn.
So, alright. I'm on the ground, 2 broken arms. Alright.
Yep.
Can I try to set up? Yeah, can I try to set up my M1903A3 on my arm on my splinted arm and use and try to, you know, shoot this guy over here.
Roll me a con save. Which guy?
The one across the courtyard.
Oh, yeah, roll me a con save. Yeah, you can do that.
Sweet. So
it's a pain to shoot him.
Alright, so I guess that's one action for one aim.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Here's your crit to do it.
And trying to stealth.
Pretend to be dead.
No shit.
All right.
Fuck it. Next time I'm sighting in.
So this guy, emboldened by the arrival of the new Roman, sees Olaf's bubble shield, and as he looks in the bubble shield, he flips him off.
Olaf reaches out of hand, grabs it, and puts it in his pocket. He's like, "Say that one for later."
And then he goes into this room. Right, and the guy in front of Zach's turn. He is gone.
Oh, that guy's so fucked.
Which guy?
Homie right here.
Oh, okay. Alright, this guy, he's going to swing and wow. Miss. Well, you don't even have to react. He misses with his knife, Zach.
Oh, good.
Guy over here, he doesn't like being shot at. Who the fucking fuck is that?
That was my phone. This is my mom.
Over there. Olaf.
Yep.
Your turn.
So he came right there.
Yep.
Chicky bricky.
That will both of those hit.
So he's taking 9 spread shot rounds with full etch.
Yep.
Okay. 8, 9, 7. I'm just going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6. All right.
So whatever that is, it's plus 45. 9 times 5.
Such a fucking good song. God. Pisses me off.
What are we talking about?
Sorry.
What you talking about, Phyllis?
I'm just listening.
Listen to
Slavic
Hard Base.
No. I'm not.
71.
Oh, yeah, he did. Move him from the turn of order. Next time it's his turn. Alright, where is this guy at? I'm pretty sure this is. So this dude deactivates the bubble shield.
Oh, here we go.
Yep. And. He's going to pop off a... Oh, God.
He popped off a nasty round. Sounds like it.
Yeah, he did. He moves around Brutus. Take 8 ballistic damage.
I take 8 yep. Ballistic?
Yeah, bud. He faked you out.
So he does have a gun.
Yeah, he does have a gun. He's got a tomahawk in one hand and a 1911 A1 in the other.
Okay.
Yeah, and they're much better with those than me.
Psych!
Like, no. Bitch, you thought?
Yeah, bitch, you thought.
Alright, that being said, it's now Zach's turn.
Well, I guess I'm gonna continue on my way of doing things.
Alright. only damage.
20. Yeah, he did. Nice, Zachy.
He's dead.
Fucking time. Fuck.
Go. Might have had him a Aloha snack bar. Alright, so the guy behind Brutus, seeing as he can't shoot Preach because the bubble chill, he's gonna shoot Brutus. Oh, he missed. And he jammed.
I've got the shield up anyways, so it would have been half.
He jammed. Doesn't matter.
What a puppet bitch.
What a lucky fucking bear.
Fucking tall.
What a very lucky bear.
Ha! Gay!
So, real quick, Zach. Yeah, I mean, you're not taking damage. You hear the telltale sound you've come accustomed to of a military rig firing up.
Sounds like a good time.
Yeah.
Hey, Billy.
Hullabully.
I got a... Game requires a lot of math, I'm sorry.
It does. This one requires a lot of math.
Pathfinder on math.
And it's really only for the damage rolls, too.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Your bubble shield shatters as it just gets lit up by automatic fire.
So that thing took, goddamn, something hit it for 79. Okay.
Something hit it for 93.
Oh, I'm okay.
Somebody's got an MG42.
Yeah.
Oh, an FG42.
Well, I want. Oh, I want.
Military rig.
I want Big Al the Hundrel.
You're lucky they don't have an MG42. That's a burst of 15.
Yeah, I know what it is.
All right, this guy's turn. He's gonna continue his maneuver over here. And he's gonna take a single shot with his weapon. Olaf, who will have half cover.
So plus 6, got it.
Miss.
Thank God.
Preach, your turn.
All right. I'm gonna pivot and light this dude up. This dude.
Alright.
So, hey diddle diddle, right. Let's get the biddle.
Alright.
Oh.
That will actually hit. He's kind of in the open.
Oh, it will?
Yep, all of it.
Good bitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Don't even tell that. He's dead. The first round met his DR. The next round just obliterated his remaining health bar.
That's 2 bodies I get to loot.
Yep.
Me too. They're right here beside me right now.
And this guy. And I gotta go to his sheet real quick.
This one that's right below me?
Yeah.
Okie dokie.
Run into my room.
I've got an idea.
Olaf, I need a deck save.
Oh, boy. Okay.
Never mind. I tried to save you. You should have ran.
I failed it.
You cheeky boy.
You actually did feel this one. 18 explosive. Another grenade. It flies up the stairs.
Minus 13. These are impact grenades, aren't they?
They're 40 mic mics.
Got it. One away from fucking actually having to roll an injury.
Doc, it's your turn. Oh, is this your second round of blind?
Yes.
Okay.
I could have blinded you, but after that, be merciful.
Brutus, your turn.
Yep. I'm going to turn on the athletic rig and rush this dude again.
Alright, roll me the strength attack.
The good news is you don't have to worry about that one dude behind you.
Wow.
The bad news is you have to worry about the dude. Oh, wow.
So he dodges it. But just barely. You guys are here now.
All I gotta say is duck and dive from that tomahawk.
Yeah.
For the love of God, do not let him get close.
I have the shield.
I mean, he does have that. The shield does protect a good bit against the tomahawk. The hunters in game actually can't hit me with the tomahawk.
That's very true. He's right about that.
Alright, Brutus, you still have another action. Wait, no, you're just an attack, sorry. He's up.
Alright, half movement to stand up, and then going over here, using it to cover, as cover, to peek out.
I gotcha.
Yep. Con save, right?
Yep.
13?
You're good.
Okay. I'm using the 1911A1.
All right.
This guy is
on the first floor.
Oh, I can't see him, can I?
Nope.
So, yeah. All right.
Play dead. Play dead.
I'm gonna fire at this guy.
Okay, you can see that guy. Roll me an attack.
Yeah. Give me a second. I'm going to hammer pair.
All right.
So, two attacks.
No, don't worry. I got alcohol to fix it.
Hell yeah. Already,
oh, fuck. Hello.
Are you second with Fonz purchase?
Please say that I'm hidden from him.
Yeah, he doesn't know you're there, so... That's a lot, isn't it? What, 28? 32. All right. Yeah, he doesn't like that, though.
Yeah. Scooting back into the room a bit, and then as a bonus action, stealth.
Oh, look, she finally sucked one.
Right. Odloff, it's your turn.
Well... Kadoosh, kadoosh.
First one misses, second one hits.
Aw, he only gets two.
Yeah, I know. So.
Still 11.
21.
21. Alright. He's really fucked up. Now it's this guy up here.
Is he rolling injury yet? Thank fucking God. You're welcome.
Oh, what about the guy that I shot?
Go ahead and use this one for this guy. Oh, so the force of the impact shattered one of his arm joints and it actually causes him to drop his Helsing.
Oh, good.
Wow. The weakest injury ever given by Shiza. You strained his back.
I'm using a 1911, okay?
So, see, I got a question.
I'm just glad I got something.
Yeah. I mean, a back injury does fucking hurt.
Since I didn't use all my movement to get to that door, can I use what's left of my movement to pick up his Helsing?
No, not without provoking an attack of opportunity.
I'll wait.
Okay. Zach, it's your turn. This is the guy with the military ring.
Yeah, I was going to say, I can see him, right?
Yeah.
Well, fucking, hey, diddle diddle, the cat with the fiddle.
All of that will hit.
Two Shoes McGavery, he was just confessed that he was once hired to beat a cow to death with two porcelain dolls. This is the first known case of knick-knack paddywhack.
That's great.
Totally forgot to do this guy's turn that was fighting Brutus. Wow. Oh, I'll go back to his turn real quick.
I'm okay.
I know you're okay, but no.
You gotta get the tomahawk. It has to happen.
He's gonna swing with the hatchet. I'm pretty sure that will hit, so reaction.
Which hand is tomahawk in?
His left.
So, can I use my shield to... I'm essentially aiming at his left elbow.
Okay.
With the side of my shield to stop his swing.
Okay. Roll me a counterattack.
Okay, I have no idea what that... What, like, with the shield?
Yeah, roll me a shield bash.
Shield bash?
You hit, roll damage. So he takes 10 damage. Still has on the tomahawk, but you managed to stop that from happening. But he's going to go to fire off with his pistol. And you may react against the pistol as well. Or you cannot use your shield to do so.
Then can I use the cleaver to aim at his right hand holding the pistol?
You may. You don't manage to...
Yeah, sorry, that was supposed to be the first one.
You don't manage to hit him, however, you do manage to knock the shot off course.
Okay.
And... Okay, just skip some... Yeah, that's... guy right after Zach. I also that guy. I feel like feeling this is a dead guy.
It's probably those two are before me are probably dead.
It was dead guy.
Yeah, so now it's my turn.
No, these two guys in the courtyard.
Oh yay. I didn't realize my pistol's suppressed.
Nice. So this guy down there with the military rig, he doesn't like that, so it's still running. He's going to turn to Zach, and
Zach shot him.
Yeah,
Zach did shoot him.
Zach, you have 3/4 cover against this.
Can I use my reaction to duck?
I will allow you to use your reaction to duck because he had 2 crits.
I will do just that.
All right, so you managed, you duck down as just the, I guess whatever, the wall above you just gets lit up. You now are a suppressed one.
I can deal with that.
This other guy down here, he is going to take 2 shots at Olaf. Olaf. 6 damage.
Okay.
Now it's Preach's turn.
Yay! Alrighty.
I like how everyone else gets fucked up. Preach is taking no damage. Neither has Doc, technically, at this point, either.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Peter's laying over there bleeding out.
No, he's not bleeding out anymore.
He's not bleeding out anymore. He put a tourniquet on.
Alright, oh, okay. I guess I'm gonna finally, you know, join the fight.
Olaf's gonna be like, they're that way.
I mean, you did kill the guy that was shooting Brutus in the back.
Yeah. So this guy's gonna get the first one.
Didn't he also kill the guy that threw a grenade at me?
Or actually, you know what? I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna do that, but I'm gonna do this as well.
With the 19-19?
Yeah. At this guy.
Okay, fair enough. Roll me the 3 damage rolls then. That is which he fails.
Nice. So he gets all 22.
All right. At the bottom of the stairs, turn. He's going to try to sweep his way over here. And he's the guy with the grenade launcher.
Of course he is.
He's going to use a shot. Single shot. Misses Preach. Doc, it's your turn. You're not blind anymore.
Right. I've measured this out.
Okay.
And on Zach.
You're good, buddy. Put your hand, comforting hand on your shoulder. I suddenly feel explicably better.
Let me check this real quick. 11. Heal 11, Zach.
I could deal with that.
Didn't Zach go AFK for a moment?
Are you sure you're not actually dying?
We'll find out
soon. Brutus, it's your turn.
We're all actually dying.
Yeah.
Technically, you don't.
25. Yeah, oxidation via breathing.
Oh, no, I plan on dying by 40. I've been dying for a while.
Roll me damage there, Brutus.
Fuck my liver.
Yes, sir. Cheers to that.
All right.
Second attack.
Yep, second attack. Alright. He does dip that one, though.
He dips a 28?
Yep. Nat 20 on the deck save.
Damn.
That's pretty good.
That's good job. You all are bobbing and weaving out there.
Jeez, that's your turn.
Alright. So, con save first?
Yep. You cannot fire this turn.
Alright. In that case, I'm going to stay there, you know, just trying to get my arm to move. Even though, you know, obviously I can't.
That's to say, I mean, you could stim pack yourself.
I don't have a stim pack.
I just got MC gloves again from a named enemy.
Nice.
I don't have a stim pack.
Oh.
Well, this seems like you're fucked.
Yeah, I don't know where people got them or how much they are.
They picked them up from Angelica.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you guys got a long...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right,
yeah.
This guy in front of Olaf.
What up?
I should have dropped another big hill. My bad, guys.
Can you give me
good?
A reaction?
What did he do?
Knife.
I'm going to crowbar his fucking hands.
Roll me counterattack.
Fuck!
Jeez, roll damage.
Holy shit.
So
calm down there, Mr. Freeman.
He doesn't get any attacks off. As he goes to swing with his knife, Olaf just uppercuts this dude with the crowbar.
You're just Gordon Freeman, that dude.
He is done. Olaf, it's also your turn.
Oh, is he dead?
He is done.
I'm gonna look at Preach and be like, well, okay. And then I'm going to turn around and our little grenade.
Just going to look and be like, oh, nice.
Thanks. They're... Oh, yeah, I can hit him. Okay, cool. So, with that, I'm just. Kadoosh. Yeah, no.
Three hits.
Oh, okay. Boom. And then I'm taking a knee behind this little wall.
Guy up here dancing with the devil. He's going to go for his hatchet. Brutus, you may use your reaction.
I'm actually going to react with the cleaver this time.
Roll me that counterattack. You missed, my boy. You take one slashing. You are so lucky. Actually, I didn't include a strike in his hatch attack. Sorry. You take 4 slashing damage. Oh boy. 4 slashing damage to Brutus.
Now you pissed him off.
You just poked the bear, bud.
Literally. And I need a reaction, another reaction from you, Brutus, for the pistol.
Oh, shit!
Roll me the damage. The pistol's not going off. Takes 23 damage. Zach, it's your turn.
Gooch my way. Up, just real quick, and
all right,
in one round. Yep.
5 damage. All right. Now that guy's turn. He didn't like that.
I don't care what he likes.
Well,
you will when he turns around and shoots you.
He does, and he's still running military rigs.
So... Can I jump? As my reaction to this.
Because this would probably just be a problem.
Point, I'm kind of just trying to piss him off.
Well, you're doing it.
You're doing a great job, Bush.
This guy over here, he's going to... Zach, I need a deck save.
Okay. And
wow, you just meet the DC. You are not blinded.
Thank God.
Preach, it's your turn.
So I'm gonna lay down and bye bye, shithead.
There's a barricade in front of you.
Oh, is there?
Yeah.
Then never mind. He's still getting the full thing.
Okay. Which one?
This dude.
All right, you get...
How many does... Two, at least.
Two hits.
Two hits?
Yep.
Oh.
Why aren't you Misty Step again?
No, I get...
Fuck. I'm... Screw that, Z. I'm Misty...
Oh, okay. Never mind, then I'll just negate that. Okay, he's dead.
We're not gonna even. I'm rolling it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Angry to die. Alright, it's now this guy's turn. Breach, you're gonna hate me.
Why?
I need a deck save.
I know.
Alright, I still need a deck save from Odlof, though.
Okay.
Oh!
It doesn't matter. Is it?
Why?
Oh, is it a flashbang?
No.
Okay. 11.
As the grenade that was meant for Preach detonates on his shield, instead it sprays the shrapnel on you.
Sorry, bud.
It's okay.
It's Doctor.
Alright, motherfuckers.
Doctor!
Stay right there.
Man, too angry. Literally too angry to die.
Let me see what's gonna happen. Oh, you bastard. You're 5 feet away.
I mean, right. You can take a 5 foot step.
Up. I'm gonna do that.
There you go. Drop the bait. We got this, guys. I suddenly feel so much better every time she tells me that.
Yeah. Her voice is so angelic.
Go team!
Please don't.
Oh! Yes!
It's kind of bad. It was kind of funny.
And don't forget that goes to Peter too.
Did we all get that?
Yeah, we all got that.
I don't need it because I have yet to take any damage.
I think you're too far from me, actually.
He is also too far from you.
Well, I don't need it.
All right, is that your turn, Doc?
Yes, sir.
Rule of the toss.
How is this guy looking?
Good. He's the one hunter that we all hate. Oh, shit.
See if he gets a reaction to go off.
Can't his anger go beyond?
Is this what I tell you that it does?
No way.
Damage. Roll damage, Brutus.
Ooh! Okay. Ooh!
Ouchie!
That's 30.
How is he not tacked on an injury yet?
How? He has. He's just rolled really low. When they said you got the 100 we all hate, you got the 100.
You got the 100 we all hate. I'd rather be in this room with all these guys than that out there with him.
See, what you don't know is that's Zoob's personal character, and you'll never beat him.
No, not it at all. Alright, so you slash him with what looks like should be a fatal injury, but you can still see him smirking as he jams a stim pack in his leg.
That chode.
Fucking bitch. Oh,
you, God, still have a, you still have another attack, though. Let's roll his deck save. Doesn't save. Full damage. Let's save him. Didn't know I had to do it.
Oh, I'm by all means, like.
Can I use a stim pack myself?
On your turn? Yes, you may. On your next turn, I
should. One on my turn.
Yeah, you used it as a reaction because you knew he was about to get hit. When we say you're fighting the asshole, you are fighting the asshole.
Yeah, because you're fighting Z.
Ish, kinda. She's, you can shoot Cheeza.
Yay! So I'm going to basically stick my head out from around the corner.
Alright.
This one. He's the one I shot last time, right? Alright, so. Controlled pair.
All right.
So that is
also a miss, but only just.
Yep. Followed by my next attack being, or my next action as an attack.
Oh shit, I got a classified reclaimer.
Oh nice!
Did that hit?
Nope. Damn. Just by one.
Back to where I was, and stealth.
Flip off.
Middle dude.
Alright, roll me 1, 2, 3, 4 hits.
Okie dokie.
All right.
18.
There we go. This guy fighting Brutus. Brutus, you wanted an actual. I'm giving it to you.
Say that again?
I said you wanted an epic duel. I'm giving it to you.
Very true.
All right. So this guy. I know what he's going to do. He's going to be cool if he gets to do it. All right. So he's going to go to swing at you with his hatchet.
Reaction.
Feel free. You managed to parry the attack.
Damage.
No, it was a parry. You guys kind of were, you guys met the same attack roll, so it's a parry.
Good to go.
He swings at you again with the hatchet. There it is. And it was a feint. The ninja kicks off the shield. And
okay. Did he plant his foot on a spike at all?
No.
I'm promising you, dude. These hunters know how to position themselves.
All right. Mel.
That was supposed to be a gif. I'm pissed. Hold on.
I might just change these guys from actually hunter.
Let's see.
They work for the Legion, but they are the hunters.
Fuck it. I'm gonna pop up again and
get a limb kit, my boy. You did a one for three.
God damn it, that was subpar.
Yeah.
Oh.
There we go.
It's a free action. I'm going to flip him off and get back down. Yeah.
Oh, God.
The bubble shield, and he's gonna use that time. Pop his one thing he's got.
Right. It's good I'm not always here. You guys wouldn't get through a whole lot.
I gotta select this token. That was too fucking perfect. If Bruce asked me to kick this man in the nuts for his next attack, I would allow it. Preach your turn.
Right. Well, his buddy popped a bubble shield, so his other, this guy's gotta go.
Alright, the guy with the grenade launcher, he should probably have gone a while ago.
I've been working on him, just subpar rolls.
Yeah, he, were we gonna do it? Probably not. Not. Total it up. Let me know. Oh, boy.
34.
Jesus Christ.
Perfect amount of damage. Actually, hang on. Wow. It was the per... He dive rolled for half damage. He had P left. Cut that in half, it's 34.5, rounds up to 35.
He's
dead.
That's all I wanted to hear, Z. I didn't want to hear this long, drawn-out bullshit of how he tried, he almost survived, but didn't.
I'm just letting you know.
Almost only works in horseshoes and hand grenades.
I'm just letting you know, you killed a man by half a hit point.
0.5. That's all I needed.
Yep. Doc, it's your turn.
All right.
Don't worry, Elsa. We'll go play the underground, and you can experience this kind of fight for real.
Yup.
Just know that if I'm in a corner, some shit's about to go down.
Over there.
I can't shoot through that fucking bubble.
You can start taking damage down off of it, though.
Oh, can I?
Yeah.
Or... Hear me out. You're doing good, Olaf. Keep it up.
Oh, well, I'll take that, too.
All right.
I think more it's a bonus action.
Is it?
Yeah.
Hey. Also, Shield of Faith.
On who?
Who's getting... No. You only get one bonus action, though. What the fuck? These are all bonus actions in this? Who's being hit? Who's being hit the most?
Zach.
Yeah, Zach right now.
I'm the medic. Shoot me. Cast it on myself.
All right.
Ballsy. Ballsy as fuck.
Very ballsy.
Brutus, it's your turn.
No, bold move, Kai.
See if it works out for him.
Which way? In facing.
I mean, at you?
Okay.
He's not going to stand there with his back to a massive bear man.
Well, he did just backflip off me, so I didn't know if he landed facing
me. Okay, he didn't backflip. He, like, used you as a springboard to get away from you.
Gotcha. Okay. I'm going to turn on the athletic rig again.
Yep.
This is time number 3. And I'm going to use it to run around and behind him.
Ah.
I'd like to kick him in the nuts.
Yes.
Roll me strength. Roll me a strength attack. Wow. You missed.
Wait, I don't get advantage because of the athletic rig?
Not on an attack.
Wow, humbug.
Alright. So you moved and you attacked. That's your turn. He's not even going to react. He's not even going to react to that because it was a mess. She's up. You missed.
Alright, so I guess first thing I'm doing is voting.
Walking out. Fuck your bubble shield.
Yeah, and then I will stick my head out and fire once.
All right.
With hammer pair.
Go ahead.
So that's 2 attacks.
Roll me damage. Shooting a bubble shield.
Give me 1 second to roll the other one then real quick.
Okay. 2 damage rolls.
Do I get sneak attack?
On a bubble shield? Inanimate object.
Fair enough. It cannot be surprised.
4 damage.
Yep.
Olaf. I'm gonna use my last action to hide.
Alright.
Well, I'm just gonna fucking hey diddle diddle the fucking bubble shield.
All of the hits, roll me the
1, 2, 3, 4.
27, 14, 21, 25, 27. Alright. Guy fighting Brutus
the 3rd. Yup, go back over here and watch this shit show. I mean, Hunter versus Bear.
Brutus' inability to hit him. Yeah, that's caused him alternative lines of work. Alright. So this guy is going to turn around real quick. Catch it. Reactions, Brutus? You have to make impact yourself as a reaction.
That's so. What happened?
Getting attacked, I didn't react.
Sorry. Discord just wigged out on me. Alright, reactions are coming. What's he attacking with first?
Hatchet. Alright. You actually don't manage to counterattack the hatchet.
Oh, shit.
Wow.
And he hits you for 8.
Brutus, nay.
And he also did fire off the pistol. I need a reaction from the pistol. And you don't get to react. Out of the way, right?
Hit him. If I can smack him, that'll the way I'm aiming at him.
Ooh, that's good.
Well, you missed. You didn't parry the meat cleaver. You already put the 8 in for the slashing damage.
I'm about to.
Okay. And you take 6 ballistic.
That drops me.
I know.
Yeah.
So as Brutus drops, you know, the leader of this group sees pretty much, he sees how bad it's gone for the rest of his team. He looks down at Brutus. He says, "We'll meet again, beggar man." And he's going to start helping.
The bad thing is, none of us knows that Brutus is fighting.
Rival?
Yeah.
I gave you a rival.
Oh, yeah, I know.
I know that Brutus was fighting.
But oh, yeah.
Actually, I may or may not have actually seen him go down.
I was about to go check on Brutus. I have prior 11 soup. So that's now. I was gonna go check on Brutus and do Word of Healing. So that'd be my next action. I have to leave fine folks, so I'll catch you all on the flip side.
See you, Bill.
All right. It is now Zach's turn.
Later, guys.
Right. What can I do that is really stupid? Might get me killed.
Everything and anything. Jump on the bubble shield.
My dude, so we can track him.
You what?
Tag the dude running away from me so I can track him.
What do you mean?
I can't see him from where I am.
No one can see him, bud.
I want to jump on top of the bubble shield.
Oh my god, that was not a suggestion.
No, I thought about it. I'm going to do this. It's going to happen.
Well, right. You're just not getting the tomahawk right now, buddy.
Athletic?
Wow, you're right on top of the bubble shield.
Well, this is going a lot better than I had expected to already.
You are literally right on top of this, man.
So jumping on it didn't, like, let me through or anything? Shit.
I didn't let Brutus through.
Stay right there, bud.
Yeah.
Stay right there.
I'm just gonna keep something. My. You know what?
God. Stay right there. I'm for him.
Oh, he is God. Literally above me.
No,
below me.
Yeah, he's literally below you, and you're literally about to come down on top of him. Just stay right there.
Right on, man. If he drops you. I'm gonna shoot the bubble shield then, if I can, with one hit, probably.
Roll me damage.
6.
Alright, so, probably shouldn't have listened to them, because it's his turn next.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, God.
Mine was not a suggestion, it was a dumb joke that should have been disregarded.
So seeing you land on top of the bubble shield, you hear this guy go, "You're dumb," and he just points the FG-42 up.
Can I make myself fall back?
I mean, you can react by falling back, but you're still going to take some damage from that.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm going to react and just fall back that away. Or no, that away.
Alright, I have to pull this up. Roll me a deck save.
Fuck me.
Oh.
You go deck save for half.
Fuck me.
You did this to yourself.
Yeah, I know.
Was someone slow clapping for this?
I sound like Co.
He pulled a sin.
I did in fact do that.
That is true. Oh, fuck.
That's way more health than I have.
DR.
I don't have DR.
How do you not have fucking DR?
Is that like double your HP?
Yeah, just about.
Just about, or is it?
If my HP is 40.
Oh.
Well, roll me injury. Plus, I don't know what that would be for. Plus 48.
Plus 48?
Yeah. 105. That is... So, as you get lit up by this, you also fall on the ground hard enough to break most of your ribs.
Yes.
You're not dead.
Not dead.
Riddled. Yeah, very riddled.
But you are unconscious.
You are out of the fight. You shouldn't have listened to that suggestion.
It wasn't a suggestion.
No, it wasn't. I just wanted to do something stupid.
What? Okay.
It was a joke. It was a bad joke, but it was
happened.
A joke.
It happened.
You know balls to me. You know balls to me.
It happened. Let's move on, please.
Preach.
Right on his fucking shield.
Okay, shatter. Oh. That has something special against, like, material objects, doesn't it?
Like,
if you cast shatter on, like, something made of wood?
A creature made of inorganic materials such as stone, crystal, or metal has a disadvantage on a saving throw. A non-magical item that isn't being worn or carried also takes the damage if it's in the spell area.
Okay. So it takes the damage.
Yep.
You know what? I'm just gonna say it breaks it. But it's pretty much over. That shield's done.
And then, he's gonna get... Where is it? He's gonna get the failure to stop.
Alright. Was Shatter a bonus action?
Shatter was an action.
Failure to stop. Action. Full round action.
Oh, then never mind. He's only going to get a hammered pair.
Alright.
Well,
fuck. Oh, roll me.
Two
damages, yeah.
25. Jesus Christ.
Right. Doc's turn. Doc said he was going to go check on Brutus. Doc's got this window, and you're going to hear Doc yell, Brutus is down!
Very well.
I thought he was going to use healing word on Brutus.
Yeah. He has to be close enough.
It's 60 foot range.
Oh. Yeah, yep. So she drops healing word for character sheet. 8.
Never mind, I lied.
Brutus, get him.
I already took him out of the
turn. It's Brutus' turn.
I took him out of the turn order. He's like one on.
No, he's not right above me. And I still have the athletic rig. I can catch up.
I literally got rid of him just now. Because I didn't think Doc would come try to get you.
Well, put him back.
No. Brutus is going to get him. No survivors.
I want that tomahawk.
I know you want that tomahawk, but you're going to have to beat him another time. Like, just so you know, I'm actually going to make that guy a character now, and he's going to be Brutus's rival.
I need a name. Alright, so I'm up, and it's my turn?
Yep.
We shall dub him Tomahawk.
Alright. You said Stimapack?
Yeah, I'm going to use two of them.
So, 2d10 plus 10 for double jab. HP, Bruce.
Isn't a 1d10 plus 10 per stim pack?
It's 1d10 plus 5 per base stim pack.
Okay, there you go. That's 17. No, I can't move now.
Yep. It is now Sheeza's turn. You can roar in anger. Sheeza, you cannot fire.
Yeah. Damn. In that case, peek around the side, perception, and followed by an action to stealth.
All right. See that guy? He looks pretty bad. Hola.
Fuck that dude up.
None of that.
None of that, Tom.
God damn it.
Back down. That guy's up. He's turning the FG-42 on you guys. Olaf, you have half cover.
Okay.
Take 1, 2, 3 hits. 19.
19?
Yep.
Don't forget DR.
DR. Thank you. 14, and that is actually my first 34.
34 will match you a broken foot.
God damn it, me and this foot bullshit.
Yeah, broke your other foot. Just like Zach sprained both ankles that one time.
Zach, we're alike now.